What's better than an open bar, delicious hors d'oeuvres, and fabulous fashion? What if I gave you some sexy people to go along with it? We are here for Best of Style 2017. I'm about to take you around the world for Philadelphia Style 2017. I'm Nosh, and this is Social Scenes. I took you around the world, had some amazing food, saw some beautiful fashion. That's all the time we have here today on MyNewPhilly.com, where something's always new and everything's always Philly. Hey guys, we're here at the Daily News' 2017 Sexy Singles, and it's a lot of sexy people here tonight. Let's check it out. So where were you when you found out you were nominated?
I think I was in bed reading an email. Now look at
me. And then you were like, oh my God. So what's been the best part of the experience so far?
I did love the photo shoot.
But I am super excited to be here tonight. Very honored to be chosen as the Daily News single, and ready to have a good time.
All right, so I am with Misha, another one of our 2017 Sexy Singles. How are you doing tonight?
I am doing fabulous. How could you not feel good in an atmosphere like this?
It's a great event, right?
Yes, it's beautiful. And by the way, everyone looks stunning.
Everyone included.
including you.
So in planning the event, did you guys do anything differently than from last year, or how'd you go about planning the event for tonight?
Well, this year's theme was fitness, so it's all about being fit because, you know, fit is the new sexy.
And I did see the photo shoot everybody had on, like, you know, workout gear, they were in the gym. So how did you come up with the actual theme for the event?
I don't know. It's not about what you wear, it's about what you bring to the game. And it starts with how you feel about yourself, and that also starts with being fit, being healthy, having a positive attitude. It all works hand in hand.
And I obviously see why you were nominated. So what's been the best part of the experience so far?
It's a little flattering, I must say, you know, to think of all the people here in Philadelphia, my hometown. It's just an honor.
Nah, I had to put a spank on for the suit, but listen, I'm sweating profusely, but I look good tonight.
All right, guys, so you see all the sexy things behind me, but that's all the time we have for MyNewPhilly.com. where something's always new and everything is always Philly.
Welcome to Gayborhood TV, I'm your host Brandon, and they say that brunch is the new protest. And it was no surprise to me that the biggest member of the resistance is right here in our hometown of Philadelphia. Mike Heisey, welcome, thank you so much for having us.
Hi, how are you?
Folks out there might know you as Alt Fact Kelly.
That's right.
So tell me a little bit about Alt Fact Kelly and her place in the resistance.
Well, so I've protested or rallied, marched for, and done, have done advocacy for groups for 30 years. When President Trump was elected, I began protesting with just signs. After Kellyanne Conway did an interview and said that they gave alternative facts, and I dreamt about it.
So this all started as a dream?
Yes.
Literally, it was all a dream.
It was.
Yeah.
I dreamt that she was in a Barbie box, that I could not get to her, but I was arguing with her, and I couldn't hear her. And I just envisioned the Barbie box, and she was in the inauguration outfit. The next morning, I woke up, and I barely ate breakfast.
So this is, wow. And this is pretty much, like, exact replica of what she was wearing on that inauguration day.
It's close.
To let everybody know, you've made all of these outfits that you have here,
right,
correct?
Right.
So now this is your whole entire wardrobe of, let's just say, characters inspired by this new administration,
right,
correct? What does this mean to you? What's your drive behind this?
I want to give a message, elect the right people next time.
So, and you know, even for the message, you know, I guess there's a certain type of humor that's brought to it. You know, humor is the best remedy in tough times. So I feel like there's a lot of that involved too. Tell me a little bit about your experiences when you're protesting.
I always wanted to do sketch comedy. I always wanted to be an actor. My life didn't go that way, but now I can.
This is another one that, this is probably one of my favorites that I saw. Seems that you're getting a lot of great reaction out of this.
International. I actually have drag queens and other performers from around the world, Australia, France, London.
Wow.
That message me through the social media, you know, either, you know, Instagram or Facebook. And they say that my pictures and the things that I post, keep them up to date on what's going on, because you don't get a lot of,
you don't get it over there. Absolutely. Well, thank you very much for your time today. Thank you, you know, for the very creative artwork that you're putting into protesting. Next time you're thinking of going gay, make sure you check in with me. Thanks for tuning in to My New Philly, where something is always new and everything is always Philly.
For the entrepreneur, there is opportunity out there. So my name is Iola Harper, and I am the Deputy Commerce Director for the City of Philadelphia. And in that capacity, I lead the Office of Economic Opportunity. Think about a city or a municipality and all of the things that they purchase and all of the things that they pay for, from paper and pens to buildings. Our tax dollars are going to fund those purchases. My office ensures that women, people from the minority population, and disabled business owners have a fair share or have fair opportunity and access to those business opportunities. And then we also monitor projects to ensure that those businesses are receiving a fair and equitable amount of the business that the city generates. Part of this job is monitoring what we call the OEO registry. The OEO registry is a registry that consists of about 2,600 certified businesses who want to do business with the city, and we want more. So one of the first places to look is on the City of Philadelphia website, so phila.gov. When you go to phila.gov, if you click on business, you can find the Office of Economic Opportunity, and there it tells you everything about certification, what it is, and how to obtain certification as a woman or minority-owned enterprise in the City of Philadelphia. Our registry is viewed by not only city departments when they're looking for diverse firms, but a lot of the educational institutions and universities and hospitals also use our registry to identify diverse firms. I go around and I talk to all kinds of groups, professional associations, trade associations. A good idea is not necessarily a good opportunity. A lot of times, people are trying to sell something to a market that's not reachable and not enthusiastic. That's what I mean by reachable and enthusiastic. Are there people who want what you have, and can you get to them? I was honored to be asked to come and talk to the coalition. It's a very strong, gigantic group of women of color who are interested in financial literacy. They're interested in economic empowerment. And so I was able to go talk about entrepreneurship, what it means to be an entrepreneur, and specifically what it means to be an entrepreneur who wants to do business with the City of Philadelphia. Since then, I've gotten a number of emails asking questions about opportunities. So it was a good day. One of the biggest challenges for entrepreneurs, particularly entrepreneurs of color, is access. It's number one, access to capital. To have the funds to be able to grow and scale their business, but also access to opportunity. One of my favorite quotes, I had the opportunity to hear Donna Brazil speak a couple of years ago, and she said, diversity is getting invited to the party, and inclusion is being asked to dance. You gotta get into the party. And once you get into the party, you still need access to those opportunities. So my role as an ambassador and an advocate and going around talking to folks is all in the spirit of ambassadorship. I want to drive by construction sites and I want to see companies owned by women and people of color. And when you're looking at a construction boom of this magnitude, along with those types of construction booms come tremendous economic opportunity. For businesses that are in the public workspace, I'm going to say that the opportunities are boundless. That it's time to get prepared, it's time to get capitalized, and it's time to work with OEO and others to ensure that you get your fair share of the opportunities. I would love to see us reach our goal of as a city of 35% participation. That means 35% of every single dollar that this city spends will be spent with a business owned by a person of color, by a woman, or by a business owned by someone with a disability. That would be a great accomplishment and a great legacy that I can leave when I leave this role.
Cancer Who event, because it gives kids with cancer or any other person with cancer time to be free, be outside, instead of being cooped up in the hospital, in beds, having machines hooked up to you, having to get CAT scans, but this is a time to just play and have fun. I'd like to give a shout out to Al, Marjani, and everyone else who helps during this event.
Hey, this is Al Harris. I'm coming to y'all live from the Cancer Who weekend. We out here at Shepherd Recreational at 58 for Haverford. This is our second annual Cancer Who weekend powered by AT&T. We out here for a free event. The kids out here having a good time, moon bounces, free food, kickball tournament. Everything is live and ready for the community. Just a lot of free stuff, bringing the community along, and just want everybody to come together and connect, you know, for our family organization. So a few years back, I had a few family members that was going through cancer. My older cousin had breast cancer, my younger cousin had brain cancer, and my wife's stepfather had colon cancer, and he passed away. When he passed away, I saw that, you know, there's a lot of more people out here that need help and support in different ways that we can give. So I wanted to start a family style organization to where as though we can give help and we can give the support that the people really need besides giving them just medicine. We can give them emotional support. We just have a shoulder there to cry on. We're there at all their chemos, radiations, doctor's visits. So we're like an extended family to the person that's going through cancer and their family.
Welcome to Organic Living. I'm your host, Trisha Grabo, and today I am going to show you that there is more to healing than just going to your doctor or the hospital getting a script for medication. I am with Iris Wolfson of Alternative Healthcare for Women. Hi, Iris. How are you?
Hi, Trish. I'm great. How are you?
I'm excellent. What made you interested in holistic care?
I lived in Scotland for 3 years, and there was a lot of alternative medicine. There was massage therapy, there was energy therapy, there was herbalism, there was homeopathy, and so I got a very broad spectrum of what's available that I hadn't really seen here in the United States, and it got me studying.
And you own Alternative Healthcare for Women.
That is my practice.
Do you still do gynecology work? Do you deliver babies?
I stopped delivering babies some years back, but I have a full practice in holistic healthcare for women, and I work with women from preteens to postmenopausal ages.
Great, and I met you on one of my healing journeys in Brazil to the Jawn of God. I met you there, and that's how we began doing work together. Can you tell me a little bit about your holistic healing?
I use a lot of different methods. I use homeopathy, I use herbalism, I use nutrient support. I do a lot of energy work. I use sound healing with vibrational sound. I do shamanic drums and journeying. I do Peruvian whistles. So there are a variety of different methods that I use that are pretty much all energetic.
And what made you decide to use the Tibetan singing bowls on me as opposed to your Peruvian whistles or any, I know you have a crystal that you started to use.
It kind of depends on what I'm sensing. It's a lot of intuition, and some of it, the bowls are vibrational and they sink a vibration deep into the body, and I often use them after I've done some energy work so that the energy sinks really deeper into the system and stays with people. The energy work does a different thing. It balances and harmonizes the system. So it's all slightly different, and it just depends what the presentation is that someone gives me, what I think might be helpful for them. I do believe all healing is self-healing.
Yes.
And we just need a little prod in the right direction.
Right.
So that we can see what it is going to work for us and where we need to go.
And thank you so much for having me today and showing all the different methods that you use.
It's a pleasure to be with you.
It's great. The energy works. The energy in this room is amazing. Well, that's all the time we have on Mindy Philly, where something's always new and everything's always Philly.
Did you know at this very moment you could be teaching yourself to be afraid of something? For example, a new decision with your job, a fear of spaces, or a fear of spiders. I'm Dr. Rubina and you're watching The RX, and today we're going to talk about how to unlearn your fears with Calliope Barless. She's the author of this amazing book, Phobia Relief, From Fear to Freedom. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me.
So we can actually unlearn our fears.
We sure can, because they say that we're only born with two fears, the fear of falling
right.
and the fear of loud noises.
Interesting, interesting.
Which means that everything else can be unlearned.
So if you're afraid of clowns, per se, we can unlearn this.
That's right.
The fear of heights, we can also unlearn that.
Absolutely. However, I would want someone to have some amount of fear of heights so that they stay in a safe place.
Right, yes.
Right? Super simple, because most of the time when people fear, it's a great big picture inside their minds.
Okay.
And when we shrink it down to the size of a cell phone screen and blink it black and white, it changes how they feel.
Okay.
The second step is to actually take the most dramatic memory of when they had the fear and actually reverse it, like tapping on a remote, rewind, so everything moves in reverse. All the sounds go in reverse, and so do the feelings. And then once you get to the beginning of that memory,
right.
you blink that black and white. And that makes the feeling even less of being so irrational.
Wow.
And then the last step, step three, is to start building in the future that you want. So that whenever you're at a height, you're comfortable enjoying the scenery. Or if you see a bug that once scared you, you can at least figure out, okay, it's all right for me to be here safely and sort of laugh at it because it's certainly not going to do anything huge.
Right.
If that's the case.
Right, right.
But I want someone to, if they're in a jungle or in a place where they see a snake or a poisonous spider, to think, yes, I do need it to get into a safe place.
Why was it so important for you to write this book?
For many reasons, but the first being that I had my own fear of public speaking.
Okay.
And and from what I understand,
that's common.
It is. Yeah. It's the most common, most feared fear on the planet.
Right, right.
People would rather be in the casket than give the eulogy. Once I decided that I needed to get these skills out there, I had to get over my own fear of public speaking.
Wow.
So I did, and I decided to write in a book because it's important for people to know that they don't need to suffer.
That's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching My New Philly, where something is always new.
And everything is always Philly.
We're here today at the gorgeous 1363 North 31st Street. It's Fairmount in Brewerytown. We're right off the Schuylkill Banks, and that's how Brewerytown got its name. All the brewers in the 19th century in Philadelphia were located here because they could source their water and make their beer. It's such a cool neighborhood, it's very hot, and I can't wait to show you the loft downstairs. This unit is a two-bedroom. There are also one-bedrooms and studios available for rent here. Guys, the amenities are endless here. You saw the roof deck and the terrace and the pool. It's gorgeous. Not only that, but Flying Fish Craft House is downstairs. They offer all of their residents 10% off food and beverage, as well as free room service. So if you want to live in sort of an industrial loft in the city, this is the place for you. Throughout the entire unit, there are these huge historical style windows. They're exposed HVAC and exposed concrete beams. All the floors are a polished concrete as well. The ceilings are 14 feet in here. So if you want to live in sort of an industrial loft in the city, this is the place for you. Modern living is all about wide open space. I love this loft because it's very modern, but it's also got a ton of history. I'm going to take you downstairs so that you can see the original loading dock for Acme Foods. It's super cool. Come on, guys. Everything about this property is awesome. You're super close to Northern Liberties, you're a couple minutes drive from Center City. There's everything you need here. There's nightlife, there's food, there's a 24-hour concierge service. If you want more information on this property, all you have to do is reach out to the main desk. The concierge will give you all the information you need. That's all the time we have today for My New Philly, where something's always new and everything's always Philly.
Our business is Resi Marshall. We operate in between what the residential real estate business and the commercial real estate business. So being part of the Shark Tank Philadelphia was a natural partnership for us. I think it's a great opportunity for Philadelphia. Most of the real estate networking events are more based upon just networking. And today, Alpha Funding is actually going to do something and teach people about underwriting a deal and how to get a deal done, whether you're a seasoned investor or a first-time investor. So RE/MAX at Home is excited to be a partner with them, and we look forward to many more future opportunities.
I'm here with the Better Than Success Real Estate League. We're on at 2424 East York Street. The reason I came to this event today is because as the league and how we're growing our league, we want different members to teach them about real estate. Every week we have different people talk and talk about real estate, talk about funding. And coming to these events, I get to network, meet people, and create more relationships with established real estate investors. And what we do is we interview them every Wednesday at 7 o'clock. We talk, we break bread with each other, and we share deals with each other. Me in real estate, I've been in real estate since 96. So all my connections, they come through. We just had a great event with over 100 people, great speakers, and these kind of events I love to support and be a part of.
Made sense to sponsor this great event because of the people that are here. Anybody that's interested in real estate, what I do is look at either their credit or their business credit. And those two things together are pretty much the number one, maybe the number two thing that puts a deal through. So we've worked with a lot of different groups on the venture side and some of these house flipping projects and the Shark Tank ideas to help them get money. And how do we help them? Well, we improve their credit. I'm new to Philly, I haven't been here in a while, and I'm amazed by the atmosphere and the, let's call it, attitude of the people walking around. There was a lot of smiles, so it looked, I was really shocked by how many dogs are out there. Oh my goodness, this place is rocking.
My name is Joe Scarice. I'm with First Trust Bank. I'm a residential mortgage loan officer. I sponsored this event because I believe in networking is your net worth. And I think the Shark Tank is a great example of putting people together for networking, education, and opportunities.
I handle title insurance nationwide, but primarily in the tri-state area for Pennsylvania, Delaware, and New Jersey. That way I can meet with clients and really give them the service that they need for their title insurance and their real estate transactions. The reason why I'm at this event is to meet builders, investors that would like to connect with other real estate professionals to help their business grow in the tri-state area.
Hello and welcome to Backstage Pass with the Kimmel Center. Today we are at the Academy of Music, and as you can see behind me, these gentlemen are loading in for the show Wicked. I am so excited to get in here and to see how this show comes together. Check it out. So how much does it take to put this show, a show of this caliber, together?
Well, we start months out with communication and paperwork, but then we just started setting up. So we have 2.5 days to get set up. You know, things are being unloaded and set up. The orchestra is rehearsing. We do an orientation, sound check. So it's a quick turnaround.
So for the folks out there that maybe aren't familiar with the show Wicked, what can you tell them?
You know, what's wonderful about Wicked is I think everyone has some sort of history with the Wizard of Oz growing up, whether it's being scared of those flying monkeys or the witch's cackle or
I definitely was.
Right? And our story kind of tells you where all of that stuff kind of comes from. It's what happened before Dorothy dropped in. It's a very fun and clever book. And it's also a great score by Stephen Schwartz. I mean, some wonderful music that's being performed.
As you can see, all of the parts are coming together, and Wicked is definitely a show you do not want to miss. Wicked will be here at the Academy of Music now through August the 27th. But that's all the time we have on My New Philly, where something is always new, and everything is always Philly.
MyNewPhilly.com highlights the people, places, and events that make Philadelphia the best place to live, work, play, and visit.
Of course. I mean, I have a network that's launching probably late February, early March, called the Laugh Out Loud Network. And that's what the network is about. It's about finding the next thing, the next guy, the next girl, that next piece of comedic talent, that next great content creator. You know, eventually I want to compete with the hugest brands in the world, but you start off small.
I mean, can you see Ben Franklin Bridge from here? It looks so small from up here.
Ben Franklin, look at William Penn. City Hall is still standing strong. Wow.
Convention center right over there.
Yo, what's up? I'm Motor Mike, aka Mike Kern. I'm here with the Philly Tour Hub and some members of my new Philly crew.